Consumer price inflation surged to 7.35% in December, the highest since July 2014, and above the Monetary Policy Committee's target band of 4 plus or minus 2%. A surge in food prices and the telecom tariff hikes are said to be the main culprits. Let's welcome in Soumya Kanti Ghosh, Group Chief Economic Advisor to State Bank of India. He's joining us right now to help us understand the fine print of the inflation numbers that we saw. Did it surprise you? I mean, this has definitely come in much higher than even the most pessimistic estimates by most on Bloomberg poll.
Yes, I think the estimates we had were acting close to 7%. 7.35% is a negative surprise, but the inflation is driven by GOP, basically garlic, onion and potato. So that actually, if you strip out the impact of these three commodities, the inflation rate declines to 4.48%. And the impact of telecom tariff is also around 16 basis points. So if we exclude all these four items, the inflation is actually at 4.32%. So that's one aspect. The second aspect, however, is that the inflation has still not yet peaked out. In January, it is likely to cross 8% or close to 8%. So, and after that, it will bottom out. But as of now, the inflation trajectory remains a little bit of concern to the policymakers.
Mr. Ghosh, just the fact that we're talking about the possibility of this lasting a bit longer, till when do you see this? Because some of them are even pegging in April, till when you'll actually see these inflation numbers looking a bit more heady. And therefore then, does the RBI have any wiggle room considering growth is also becoming a big question mark?
See, actually that's a conundrum. So growth is weak, inflation is rising, and I don't think April the inflation will be reversed. Will decline to comfortable levels. Inflation will start declining after January, but to get into comfortable levels, we may lead after June or July. So in that sense, I think the RBI will be in a spot to cut rates or not. I believe that rate cut as of now is not materially possible if you just look into the inflation trajectory. But the good thing is that over the year, inflation will decline, and possibly from December to January, it could go to as much as low below 3%. So, but as of now, growth remains weak, inflation is rising, and that will be a concern to the policymakers.
Well, as it should be. Soumya, good morning. Neeraj here. Just one a quick follow-up. The one constant that will now stay in inflation and maybe actually move up would be telecom rates, right? We haven't seen high telecom rates until November or December, and they seem to be on a higher trajectory now, probably even more so. Could that be the constant worry, or you do not think that will be a big driver?
No, see, inflation, we had actually estimated that the total impact of telecom tariff hike would be around 40 basis points, or it could be higher than, 40 to 50 basis points. 16 BPS have already come through in December, and possibly another 10 to 15 could come in January. After that, it remains to be seen how that is spread out, because it is possible that an increase in the telecom tariff could also lead to some amount of demand moderation. So maybe another 15 basis point of impact on the telecom tariff, but the point is that after that, it remains at that elevated level for a long time, even though it may not incrementally add to the overall contribution to inflation. So in my sense, there will be impact on the inflation trajectory, but it remains to be seen that how that plays out.